Hello, my name is Camilo. I'd like to take a moment to tell you about a friend of mine. He's a good, honest, hard-working man. A laborer in the United States. My friend fell on concrete throwing ice melt. Two other people fell on that same day. He lay on that icy ground feeling like he had broke every bone in his body. The man came completely off the ground when all 300 pounds of him came down. Well, sir, it was bad. My friend was hoping that no one in the building, none of the staff, had seen him fall, but when he came in, one of the secretaries came rushing up. It had gotten through the building that he had fallen down. She encouraged him to go to the hospital to get checked out, but being a stubborn man, he said he could work through the rest of the shift and then go and get checked. The secretary said, "Well, we have a good nurse here on staff. Have her look you over." And thank you, Jesus. This nurse said you really have to go and get checked out. You know the people that you work for. She had him do some range of motion and he struggled. And he had ringing in his ears. The lights that were above his head had a blue tint to it. This nurse said you really have to go and get checked out. You know the people that you work for. You're expected to lift. And when you can't, you won't have a job anymore. Well, sir, my friend went to the emergency room. They did the diagnostics that they could there and referred him to an organization that had ties to the workers' comp insurance company. The man had a concussion, but before he left, this physician gave him his medical records, his doctor records and medical records, and told him that he had to turn it into his employers. What? This violates my HIPAA. What? I can't do this. She said, "You have to. If you want to receive workers' compensation, if you want your bills covered, you have to do this." Had never been in to complain about his knees, but now, with the fall, there were two torn meniscus. Never been into his doctor to complain about spinal pain, but now there were cuts in his actual spine that had nothing to do with age-related. It had everything to do with the fall. And now there were two torn rotator cuffs. When arrived at the second medical facility, he met Dr. Gates. Dr. Gates was a kind woman who was very frustrated with what she was seeing. Dr. Gates asked for to draw up a diagram of where he was hurt, and he drew a picture being injured knee to neck. She sent him for a body scan, and everywhere that man said that he was hurt, there was injury there. Before they could get to his knees, they shut it down. And this is how they did it. We're scheduled to go see a surgeon about the torn rotator cuff. An MRI had already been done, showing the tears in the arm. The physician said that I'm sending you to a surgeon who is notorious for sending injured people back to me and saying that there was nothing wrong with them and that we don't know what we're doing over here, that we don't know how to read MRIs. And for the first MRI, and it showed the injury, the physician said, "I'm sorry. I'm going to have to send you back for another test. This is an arthrogram. They will shoot a dye into your arm and do another MRI. I need to send you with two tests for this man to see, so he doesn't call me a liar, so he doesn't call you a liar." He went to the surgeon, who said that there was nothing wrong with his arm, that you could compare Cruz's arm to his arm in an MRI, and they would look exactly the same. She said, report that man. Now, this physician had put under a 5-pound weightlift restriction because of the damage to his neck, because of the cuts in the spine, because of his complaints about his knees, because of the torn rotator cuffs. She said, I want your employers to know that your injuries are serious, and I am sick and tired of your employers pressuring my patients to work outside of the restrictions that I set for them, and I am sending them a message. When he made his complaint, a series of second opinions took place. He was sent to lots of doctors who smiled in his face as he told him that he was in great pain and please, I need help. And then those doctors minimized his pain. And the end result was he lost his, Dr. Gates lost his restrictions. And ever since, that man has lifted anything they told him to lift. He's done everything above and beyond because he knew poverty. And on that very day, there were two other people who fell on the ice who received medical treatment and their bills paid by the workers' comp system. But he was told to figuratively get to the back of the bus. Lifted anything they told him to lift. He has worked so hard. And sometimes people make fun of him. And they say he's faking. The physician wanted her message to be sent. Message sent.